Hey, now it's The Rob from 106.1 Kiss FM here with my tag team partner in podcasting.
Hey guys, it's me, Steve, web contributor to 1061evansville.com.
We are proving once again that we are clearly the best stressed podcast on the internet. We're both looking good today, Steve.
Yeah, we are.
All right, let's get this thing started because I have really, especially yesterday, it hit me how important this week is for WWE and to not screw this up. I mean, there is the SmackDown moving to Tuesdays, SmackDown moving live, the brand extension kicking off, the draft special, there's the CWC and NXT on Wednesday night, and there's a pay-per-view on Sunday.
Yes, a lot of news.
I mean, it is a full-time job being a wrestling fan anymore, but Steve and I are going to try to keep you covered. NXT and CWC we probably won't be covering very much this week, but we'll let you know about the pay-per-view and the brand extension special, the draft special that happens tonight on a live SmackDown, which I'm kind of excited for. I'd probably be more excited if I didn't have to dedicate 3 hours to Raw last night. But hey, we'll do it for you. It's the sacrifices that we make. All right, Steve, you want to talk about overall impressions of the show here, or do you just want to go note by note? How do you want to handle this?
If I'm talking overall impression, I'm confused, so let's hit it note by note.
Okay, well, here, I'll tell you some of the things that jumped out at me last night.
Okay.
Last night, one of my criticisms I will not say is that it did not necessarily feel like a filler show like the previous four or so Raws have to me. I do feel like stuff finally happened to get us ready for tomorrow. Whether that stuff is good is up for debate. I'm not saying it's all bad. I'm not saying it's all good. I'm just saying we'll talk about it here.
Okay.
So the first thing that happened, the show did start off with a bang, so to speak.
Yes, it did.
A bang, for lack of a better term. I will be honest with you. I'm okay with Mick Foley being brought back as a GM.
I am too, and I was actually surprised that was her pick.
Yeah, I kind of thought it was lame at first because we've been here before, and I can get tired of Foley, and I can get tired of Foley pretty quickly. I hope that doesn't happen with me, but I am excited to see him back, especially when I saw Mick interacting with the guys in the back, especially like the undercard guys. Whether it's the Ascension or whether it's Breezango, or I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. I don't know if it's Breezango or Breezango, but whichever it is.
Yeah, Breezango, I believe.
Yeah, I think they should go with Breezango personally, but I think they are Breezango. It was just irreverent, stupid, and kind of funny, which was something that it made me want to see more. Daniel Bryan is also a good choice.
Yes.
Clearly, the crowd was into it. I don't know. This will be the best fit for him personally. Like, this is going to make me long for him as a wrestler again.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like he hasn't been gone long enough to miss him as an on-screen presence. But it's a solid choice.
Yes.
Are you aware that WWE mistakenly leaked that information earlier last week?
I was made aware probably like 5 minutes before the show came on.
Okay. So I do think that kind of took the wind out of my sails because I did realize who it was going to be and... you know, it is what it is.
Yes.
I'm curious to see what they can come up with. I'm curious to see if his personality and character will be enough to handle running or just filling a spot like that.
Yeah, if it leads to the McMahons being on TV less, I'm all in.
That's the thing. That's one of my notes here is there's too many McMahons. And while I do think it's stupid that they have commissioners... if the McMahons are really running the show, why do they need commissioners? Right. I am excited who they are and that it means less McMahons.
Yes.
It's been too much lately.
Yeah.
So we agree there, it sounds like.
Yes, we do.
I think that Enzo had another great week, or another great night at least, last night.
Yeah.
Not only that, everybody who was cutting a promo last night in that tag match did a great, great job. Usually those promo fests, I think... are dumb.
Yeah.
I don't like when it's just like guys cut a promo, then the next team comes out, cuts a long promo, and then cuts another long promo, and it seems very organized to me, very not fluid, not organic.
Yeah.
But last night, everyone was just on. I just thought those promos involved in that that 12-man tag last night were on. The match I didn't care so much about.
Yeah.
I didn't. I would just see that seemed like kind of some filler stuff.
Yeah, I feel like during the promos. You have six guys in the ring, And one of the one that doesn't want to be serious is John Cena, the one that's known for poopy jokes.
Yeah, exactly.
And it just hit me strange.
You know, so I enjoyed that in a segment. I was kind of like, if you would have just told me that's what was going to happen, I'd probably like, I don't know if I want to see this. But the way it played out, especially with Enzo, I just loved it. Yes. I thought that he's doing a great job specifically. I wrote that Darren Young better enjoy this push while he has it, because I don't know how long this one's going to last for him.
No.
But it is a push, and it is a legit push.
Yep.
And Bob Backlund, once he appears on camera, has been helping him. So, and I will also say, going into Sunday, I don't know who's going to win that Intercontinental title.
Yeah, I mean, they at least make it believable that he could win.
So, kudos to that. I'm not going to say this is an A-plus angle.
Yeah.
But they're doing something.
Yeah, they are doing something.
So they made something out of nothing. Let's see. What else have I written down? Oh, okay. So Seth Rollins had a promo in the empty arena.
Yeah.
I thought that was a nice touch.
I did like that.
Also, leading up to the match, Dean Ambrose had the Shield-type promo, like a throwback promo. Yes. I thought that was a nice touch. It didn't even matter what they said. I thought those were just nice elements to the show.
They were.
That I thought did a good job of leading into the main event tonight, making it feel big, and giving it that big match feel that sometimes Raw doesn't have. Whether it had that feel or not, I'm not positive, but at least they tried.
Yes.
You know? And they did lead me into the main event thinking, when you combine the fact that tonight is the draft, the next night is the draft, anything could happen.
Yes.
I did not know what was going to happen, and we will obviously get to that here in a little bit. I have thoughts about the main event. I did write down that I love Breezango, as I mentioned earlier. Watching them interact with Foley, as subtle as it was really funny to me, and they're making me laugh hard. I like those guys.
Yeah, and if anybody was still holding on to hope for Ascension, they have truly been buried. They have now went to humor.
Well, you know, is it better than nothing? Maybe. But yes, if there was any doubt that they were buried, I mean, we might as well cover them in dirt at this point.
Yeah.
The throwback Ambrose promo, and then, I mentioned all those things. I have nothing until the main event. Is there anything you want to mention from the show?
I want to mention the Natty came out and nobody cared.
Yeah, the women's division, I don't know if it's a combination of Dana Brooke, I don't know if it's Natty being so visible, I don't know if it's injuries that have sidelined some of the main stars. It has kind of fallen back to where it was before.
I don't know if it's went back that far, but it's definitely lost from where it was.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
All right, so the main event.
Yes.
I'm dying to know what you thought about the match, and specifically the finish of the match.
I liked the match, and then they dutied all over it with the finish.
Yes.
I was not a fan of it.
We agree completely.
Okay.
I have three words that I wrote down specifically about what I thought about the finish last night.
Okay.
The ending was lame, it was flat, and it was senseless.
Yeah.
And I'll explain what I mean by that. First of all, so the decision has been made that we're going to have two champions, it looks like to me.
Okay.
Correct? Is that what it looks like to you?
I was so upset with the ending, I didn't even get that far in my thought process.
Okay.
But yeah, that makes sense.
So it seems to me as if we're going down that road. It's a road I disagree with, but okay, that's where we're at. I feel like this was such a lazy way to get to where we're going. The double pinfall is just tired, I feel like.
Yeah.
I don't get excited for that. And then, so I do feel like it was lazy writing to go into SmackDown Live tonight. So there's that. Secondly, the execution I thought was abysmal. Not on the boys, not on the guys in the ring. The match, as Steve mentioned, I thought was fine.
Yeah.
And that suplex and the finish was fine. The commentary, like, there was no excitement. There was no sense of urgency. Nobody was asking the important questions. This should have been, like, if this were a real boxing match that ended this way, the announcers would be losing their minds.
Oh, yeah.
They would be like, what's going to happen? Like, why is this happening? Who's our champion? Like, those were not the questions being asked last night. It was flat. And you can blame it on the commentary, you can blame it on the writing, you can blame it on a combination of both. But commentary let me down in that moment as well. And then, like, so this is the stuff that I can't stand. This is the kind of writing that I find to be insulting.
Yeah.
It's just like, so, let's say someone was watching wrestling for the first time last night.
Yes.
you'd have to be a real simpleton to, like, not realize that it's fake. Because you're heading into this big draft. They've obviously made it very clear this is an important show happening tomorrow. SmackDown's changing nights. It's going live. It's a big draft special. They're changing up the rules of the game, essentially. Tomorrow is huge.
Yes.
Like, obviously, you'd have to be an idiot to not realize when you see that finish last night that wrestling is fixed.
Yeah.
And I don't, I mean, we all know it is, and I know that the notion is lost now of kayfabe and realism
yes.
and the suspension of disbelief, but I still want to be treated that way. Like, I don't want it to be so obvious that it is written. You know what I mean? And that was my big complaint about the Dusty finish last night.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, if you watch a movie, you know it's not real, but you suspend disbelief to enjoy it, and wrestling needs to be treated the same way.
Yeah,
it's a show. It's there to entertain us. Don't make it so over the top that we feel insulted because we just witnessed this.
Yeah, and is that the impression you got too?
Yeah,
it was for me also. I mean, like, there's just better ways to handle where we're going than what they did last night. And so not only is the idea bad, in my opinion, I think the destination is bad for having two champions, which I assume they're going.
Yeah,
and
then, I'm sorry, go ahead.
The execution was poorly pulled off.
Yeah, I was going to say, the only other option they have opposed to having two champions for a week is to, okay, there was this finish, so the belt's vacant until Sunday when it's decided who's champion.
Where was Dean Ambrose? Where was he? Why was he not putting up a fight when Seth was leaving with the belt? You know, obvious one person.
Why didn't Shane rip the belt out of Stephanie's hand?
There was so much that should have been going on that wasn't, and the commentary. I don't know if they were waiting for something, or if the show went off early, or what the heck happened, but they left on a flat note.
Going into tonight, they couldn't have went in more flat.
Yeah, so it sounds like we agree on the show 100% last night.
Yeah,
it's pretty
much
rare for us.
Yeah.
Unless there's anything you want to cover, let's hit what our schedule is going to look like this week.
We got everything.
Yeah, the draft is tonight.
Yep.
We'll cover it tomorrow. If you're not watching this live, today is Tuesday, we'll cover it Wednesday. And then Thursday, we'll put together some predictions for Sunday's pay-per-view. Monday, we'll come back with a live episode for the review of the pay-per-view.
Yep.
And then I don't know from there.
Yes.
I don't know if we'll do one after Monday's show, after Tuesday's show, or what. But that's what we've got immediately in the future.
Yeah, it depends on if me and Rob still have a wife and a girlfriend and our other jobs. You know, having to devote so much time to wrestling.
I don't know what to do anymore, Steve. For myself, the Rob, my tag team partner, Steve.
And that's an order!